Okay, today we're going to show you how to use a MINCO spring-loaded fitting with a tip-sensitive probe with a connection head. So the first thing that you would do is drill and tap a half-inch NPT thread into your bearing housing so that this thread can fit into the bearing housing. Once you've done that, thread the spring-loaded holder into that thread in the bearing housing, and then pull out and turn to the right the knurled knob on the spring-loaded fitting, which opens the spring inside. That allows you to slide the probe through the spring-loaded fitting until it bottoms out on your bearing surface or in the bottom of your hole in your bearing. Once you've done that, mark on the probe approximately a quarter inch beyond the knurled knob onto the probe. I'm not going to do it on this one, but you would mark it. Then slide the probe back out. Use an ordinary tubing cutter to cut the tube. Snap the tube off or cut it all the way through. Then use some small pliers to go around the inside of the tube to get rid of the burr that's created by the tubing cutter. And you want to make sure that you slide the Teflon ferrule in the end of the probe, shown right here, back into the end of the cut probe. That will ensure that the burrs do not cut into the Teflon wires. So let's assume we've already cut this probe and we're ready to reinstall it back into the bearing. So we slide the probe in. It bottoms out onto the bottom of the bearing. You then pull out and turn to the left the knurled knob, which releases the spring inside, and you'll have spring tension onto the bearing surface. Once you've done that, you want to unscrew the lid on the connection head. Sometimes the chain gets twisted a little, just move that around so that it's free. Inside is the terminal block. So all you would do is thread your lead wires. A good idea would be to cut these first to approximately 12 or 6 inches. And then you would thread the lead wires through this thread. So it's the opposite of where the opening is. And screw that onto the thread on this side of the fitting. Make your wire connections onto the terminals. And the customer usually would make their connections here through conduit onto the terminals on the other side, or onto the same side where the RTD wires are. And screw that back on, and you have a complete bearing assembly.